I know, the Shane Dawson series is over, but I promised you all a video with my beautiful girlfriend, Tristin. So in this video, I'm gonna be reacting to your Shane Dawson comments. What is up, everybody? This is Chris from The Rewired Soul, where we talk about the problem, but focus on the solution. And if you're new to my channel is all about mental health. So what I like to do is pull different topics from the YouTube community to try to teach you how to improve your mental and emotional well-being. And I did like a ton of videos on the Shane Dawson series, which is now ended. But anyways, if you're into improving your mental and emotional well-being, make sure you subscribe and ring that notification bell. So for all of my loyal, amazing, lovely subscribers out there, y'all are like, where's Tristin? When are you gonna get Tristin in a video? Tristin is in a video, but she's sitting behind the camera and she's gonna be reading Shane Dawson comments to me. So say hi, Tristin.
Hello, guys.
Yep, there she is. So she's gonna be reading me comments, and like I told, so basically what I did was I'm like, listen, just pick a bunch of comments, because I try to answer all like as many as possible. But I was like, pick a bunch of them, just read them to me. I have no idea which one she did. But like, I reply to a lot, and I'm kind of interested to see, like, I told her to get a mix of like good, bad, terrible, whatever. So yeah, let's do this. Comment number one.
I want to start out on a high note.
On a high note, okay.
hitting the like button as soon as this video starts.
Oh, that's nice. I like when people do that. But here's the thing too. I like that people do that, but it also works in the reverse where people like thumbs down it before it even starts, yeah, right? Yeah. Like, okay, so you guys, this morning when I was premiering a video, somebody disagreed with my video before the video was even up. Like, that's crazy. You guys, watch stuff before you judge stuff. All right, comment two.
All right, you've made 42 videos on Shane in the past month.
Yep, that's what we call hustle, baby. That's what we call hustle, right? And I know some of you out there are glad that the Shane Dawson series is over, but even though I did make a video about Shane and Ryland, and I talked you up a lot. And I'm wondering if Shane saw that video, because Tristin is like my Ryland. You know what I mean? Yeah.
I hope Shane.
All right, next one.
You know what? No matter what, someone has something to say. You have good intentions. I totally get you.
Huh. Interesting. I wonder what video. So we did this like 2 weeks ago, and then like our schedules got messed up. So Tristin and I were talking before, like, we don't know which videos these go with, but I'm gonna guess that was one of my videos where like I talked about, you know, people like, ooh, quit making videos about YouTubers, that, that, and that, right? And this is somebody who gets it. They get me, and they have my back, and they enjoy the content that I'm making. And by the way, if you didn't watch my video the other day about why I'm obsessed with YouTube drama, go check it out. All right, next. Hold on. Are you censoring him now?
No, I gotta figure out which ones. I believe in Shane. I knew he was gonna surprise us. I don't owe him a sorry. The people who didn't believe in him.
I love that. So that must come from my sorry Shane, like the we owe Shane Dawson an apology video. That was fantastic. That's great. Like something I've been talking with Tristin about lately. It's just like, people get upset when I talk about how we're naturally selfish and self-centered. And I love how that video has 30,000 views, right? It has like over 30,000 views. And people click on it, they're like, wait, I don't owe him crap. Y'all owe him something. It's like you would, I would assume, and I'm not calling anybody, let's just talk. But our natural reaction is to think it's about us. Like, if it was me, just in the mental state I'm at now, I'm gonna be like, oh, he's clearly not talking to me, he's talking to everybody else. But like, it's interesting that people have to comment to kind of just let everybody know, listen, I had faith the entire time. Don't tell me to apologize for nothing. There's a lot of those comments on there, a lot of them. But not everything is about you, baby.
I want you to guess who commented this.
You want me to guess who commented this?
This is why I did this one.
All right.
Not a Shane fan, so I don't care. So glad the series is over. Now we can talk about other things.
Was that Jamie?
Yeah.
That was Jamie. I love Jamie so much. I was actually just I replied to one of Jamie's comments like yesterday. I'm like, aren't you so glad the Shane series is over? And she said something funny about like, her eyes were like starting to hurt from rolling them so bad. But yes, you're welcome, Jamie. And everybody else too. Like, I was just talking to Tristin before this, like now that the Shane series is over, like I've been doing stuff. Like I've done some political stuff because of the midterms. I shared some of my personal stories. I've talked about just some other topics. So yeah. I'm glad Jamie's fully back on board now.
Can I just say, Zach's messages that he sends in the videos are hilarious and brighten the mood 10 times more.
I love that. You hear that, Zach? Dude, you hear that? But yeah, I think, I don't know if I've mentioned it in a video or just like in a live stream, but I'm really glad that Zach is helping me out with videos now, because sometimes I talk, like, because it's mental health, I talk about heavy subjects, and something I wanna do is make the mental health conversation just more casual. It doesn't always have to be this like serious, serious thing, right? So I'm glad that Zach can, you know, lighten up the mood a little bit, joke with me, poke fun at me, and we have like a good back and forth. But like Zach, one of the things I appreciate about Zach too is like, he knows when to hold back, you know? Like he knows like, okay, don't plug a joke in here, this is a serious part, da 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 da. But then he can like help get it out of that serious talk again and kind of like lighten it up just a little. And that's good too, because I'm gonna make a video eventually about joking about mental illness, joking about addiction and stuff, because that's something that I used to never do. I was just stone-faced, this isn't funny, this is serious. But like, that's just one of the way I and many other people cope, is by lightening it up. So anyways, I'll thank you for Zach. Now Zach can thank you too with a little thing.
Next one is a question.
Next one is a question.
What is the best book you've read on addiction?
What is the best book I've read on addiction? Surprisingly, maybe not. I don't read many books on addiction. So the best book I've read on addiction is like one of the only books I've read on addiction. And it's a book called Clean by David Sheff. The way I would tell my clients is like, I never went to rehab. Like, when people go to rehab, they get educated about the disease of addiction. Like, they understand like the brain and all that. And, you know, and I read the book Clean by David Sheff, and they're actually making a movie about his book, Beautiful Boy, that's coming out soon with Steve Carell. And that's a true story about him and his addicted son. But anyways, the book Clean by David Sheff, he gathered like 10 years of research about like addiction, right? And it talks about everything from like how it starts, you know, what treatments work, which ones don't work. He talks about the war on drugs. He talks about everything. So I always recommend people read that book. I say it was like rehab for me. Now, I did try to read another book called The Unbroken Brain. It's like a bestseller. It's from this former addict. She's in recovery and she's also a journalist. And she wrote one and it was like kind of arguing that addiction isn't a disease. And like, I started reading it, but I was kind of in a bad headspace and I just clearly saw that she was biased and really trying to argue her point and omitting a lot of things. So I think I gave it to one of my clients.
Okay, so this one says, I get what you're saying and yet I still agree with the former video, as I did not view it as insensitive, nor was it triggering for me.
Huh, I think I know which one this is, okay.
And then the next one starts out, it says, I like your girlfriend. It said, the last video was a bit hard for me to watch, being someone who has suffered so much mental, emotional abuse.
Yeah.
Love your videos, thanks for making this add-on video. I know you didn't mean any harm.
Yeah, so that must have been the Alyssa Violet video, and yeah, like, it's great, because I saw a lot of, you know, positive from that follow-up video that Tristin, you know, suggested that I make, because yeah, like, it's hard for me sometimes with these videos to make, like, get all of my thoughts and opinions and give you a well-rounded view of who I am, because I try to keep my videos between, like, 10 and 12 minutes, some of them go a little bit longer, but yeah, like, there's like this balance, and sometimes I'm the wrong messenger for it. Like, there's this balance between like, yes, we are a victim, and then there's like recovering, right? And we need to know what is our fault and isn't our fault. But one of the reasons I always say we talk about the problem and focus on the solution is, like, if we stay in that mentality for too long, we never get better. So like, it's our responsibility to start moving forward. So, but I'm glad I was able to make that second video and have people see, like, you know, I'm not blaming Alyssa for everything that happened, and, you know, but I think it's important that we separate certain things. But yeah, I don't know. It's tricky doing YouTube videos from a male perspective on female topics sometimes. I'll say that. I will say that. All right.
Okay, so these two also kind of go together.
All right.
I prefer your analysis of the Shane Dawson series to the series itself.
Oh, that was nice. That was nice.
Thank you for all of these videos you do. I came here because of your Shane videos. Mental health is a tricky subject to discuss.
Yeah. Yeah, and I love that. Like, I shared something on my Instagram. I put it in one of my videos too. Like, I like that. I like that people are able to see what I'm doing. I'm able to teach mental health by bringing in a different subject. But anyways, Tristin and I were actually talking last night about something that kind of irked me a little bit. But we were talking about, like, you know, teachers, right? Like, I look at myself as kind of like a mental health teacher. I'm trying to educate people on not only about mental health, but also solutions for it. But like, a good teacher, in my opinion, or teachers that I could relate to, because everybody has different learning styles, like, a good teacher is gonna find something that you could relate to, right? They're gonna find something like, whether it's math or science or physics or history, they're gonna find something that you can relate to and help you understand it better. You see what I mean? Heck, I do it with my son, right? Like, if I'm talking to him about certain things, maybe it's better for me to, you know, make an analogy that's with Fortnite. Or I remember when he was even younger, talking about good and bad people, I would talk about Marvel superheroes and Marvel villains, or Star Wars or whatever. That's just my style of teaching things. So I'm glad that people are finding me, like, their entry was something like Shane Dawson or other YouTube stuff going on, but now they're here learning how to improve their mental health. So I appreciate you.
Says, okay, I have to say goodbye. I may revisit your channel when they're far enough removed from the Shane Dawson series that there won't be any more videos about it. Take care.
Yeah, that's cool. That's cool. I had a lot of comments like that. And like, just so you all know, like, I really don't care. Like, Tristin and I were talking earlier, like, so many YouTubers are so afraid of losing subscribers. So afraid, and they bend and they shift, and they don't have this like solid sense of like who they are and what they believe in and all of that. And something I want to teach all of you is like, be who you are and stay true to who you are. Like, I lost a lot of people during my Shane Dawson series and gained a lot of people. Like, there's a lot of people who just didn't understand that, you know, these weren't all about Shane, they weren't all about Jake. Like, in every one of those, I can go through the list like I did in a different video, they're all topics that pertain to you. And I remember, like, a lot of times I don't even argue with that, but I think it was on the Team 10 House one, and I was, I was saying Jake Paul needs to get out. It was that video. And somebody said that. Somebody said, like, oh, I'm tired of these videos about Jake Paul and da-da-da-da. And I asked him, I said, have you ever had problems with a roommate? Have you ever had problems with family members living with you too long and overstaying their welcome? And they're like, oh, I get it. So yeah, like, if I lose people because of that, that's fine, because I have a bunch of you who understand exactly what I'm doing with those videos. So peace out.
And sometimes I compliment people and they reply that they're not interested.
Yeah, what video was that?
I remember there was a compliment video where a lot of people said, like, people don't take my compliments, though.
Yeah, I don't know which one that was, but, like, here's the thing, okay? Like, I think I remember saying, like, just keep giving compliments. Just keep doing it. Like, if they don't accept it, like, that's cool. Like, so the problem is, let's talk some mental health real quick. The problem is that your expectations are screwed up. When you give a compliment, you're expecting them to receive it, right? When you're giving a compliment, you're expecting them to react in a certain way. If you just start giving compliments, not expecting anything from the other person, you'll stop caring as much about how they react to it, right? So, like, I compliment people left and right. Oh, that was my butt kisser video. Yeah. That's what it was, right? Yeah. Like, I just give those compliments left and right. Don't be afraid. So again, like, we gotta understand that our fear of giving compliments is because of what other people are gonna think, even if it's the person receiving the compliments. I would not be where I am today if a bunch of people didn't just compliment me on my improvements of my mental health or my sobriety or anything like that. So let me tell you this. I'm gonna share a short story real quick. When I got clean and I went into sober living, I was miserable. I just had like this resting B-word face all the time, and I just looked like I wanted to fight everybody and everything. And there was a guy in my sober living house who moved out, and I didn't see him for like a month or two, and we went to some event, and I ran into him, and like, he was like, Chris, he's like, you look like you're doing great. I'm like, what, really? And he's like, yeah, man. He's like, I've never seen you smile before, and you've been smiling all night. And like, that meant a lot to me. Like, I was very awkward at that point still. I didn't know how to react to it. But like, this is something that I remember from 6 years ago. Like, think about how silly and trivial that compliment was. But for someone to say that, like, they see me improving, they see me smiling, I seem happier, like, that meant a lot to me, and I still remember it 6 years later. So keep giving compliments no matter how they appear to receive it.
This one just says, hope you get more subs, you deserve more.
My favorite compliment. By the way, okay, so check it out. So I did a Patreon Q&A the other day, and like, I talked about, you know, like, supporting the channel, you know, then I'll like answer questions in a video and all of that. Like, listen. I don't care. Like, I was broke for a long time. For any of you who don't know about 12-step meetings, they have something called the seventh tradition. You put a dollar in the basket. For years, I didn't put a dollar in the basket because I was broke. I know a lot of you are watching this video as well who are broke, right? That's cool. I ain't hating on you for it. But Like, when I get compliments like that, by the way, that's my favorite compliment, is like, your channel should be bigger. Like, listen, if you want to just return the favor if I've provided you with any value, just share my channel, share my videos with people. Like, all I wanna do is reach more people to help them out with their mental health. So if you think my channel should be bigger, just go share my stuff with other people. That's it. Put it on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, whatever you gotta do.
And this one is my last one. This is also one that I wanted to answer because about what I said to you.
Oh, okay.
So it says, is it just me? I can't understand those text messages you received. I agreed with everything you said and you weren't being harsh at all. It's about the Alyssa Violet video where I said my opinion about it and you put up my little...
Did I?
My text messages.
Yeah. Okay.
So I just wanted to say that, like, even though Chris has, like, a lot of knowledge about mental health and everything, he doesn't have everyone's perspectives on things, so he needs other people's input sometimes. That's just how it is. That's how everyone is. So.
Yeah. Yeah, no, absolutely, and I'm glad that Tristin does that and stuff, because that's something I always try to remember. See, that's actually one of my biggest pet peeves, is when people think that their perspective is the only perspective, right? We see it a lot with addiction, right? Where people are like, I just quit on my own, right? I'm like, okay, that's cool for you, but that doesn't mean everybody. But sometimes I can do it too, and then I have Tristin who can open up my mind and say, hey, Chris, remember, like, this isn't everybody's experience, right?
Yeah.
So, Jamie, sorry we had to make one more Shane Dawson video until the next series happens. But anyways, yeah, Tristin and I are moving in a couple weeks. We're gonna get some new lights and setup and stuff, and she might actually appear in one of my videos, not just voice. But yeah, and we're thinking about, like, doing a podcast and stuff, and because we have awesome conversations. Awesome conversation. So yeah, but anyways, I love all of you. Keep leaving comments. And if you like this video, like, let me know down in the comment section. If you like just me kind of randomly reacting to your comments, and I don't know if you enjoyed this or not, but I thought it'd be a fun video to do with Tristin, and boom, says right there, let's have fun. So say bye to everybody, Tristin.
See you guys.
Anyways, if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. If you're new, make sure to subscribe and ring that notification bell. And a huge thank you to everybody supporting the channel over on Patreon. You are all amazing. And I'm actually rocking the shirt that Tristin designed for me. All right, if you would like to get one of these shirts so we can be twinsies, you can click or tap on that merch icon right there. All right, thanks again for watching. We'll see you next time.